it's great to be here at in Lexington, Virginia, once again, this beautiful town.
Yeah, it really is a great pleasure to be back. As you might have noticed in the program, we've got a bunch of pieces that we're going to play, and we're mostly going to follow that. We're just going to change the order.
A lot of times we decide on a program before we've actually learned some of the music. And so things can change a little bit. And so we've changed a few of the pieces and a few of the order tonight.
Yeah, and one piece we're going to change just a little bit. But we're going to start off with the same piece that it says in the program, and that is the Sonata Fantasy by Matthew First.
And this is the first piece that Matthew First wrote for us back in 2001, I think.
Yeah.
And Jasper and I had a tour coming up, and that was always a good friend of mine from the Eastman School, and he was doing a degree at the Juilliard School in composition. And I said, we have a tour coming up. Why don't you write a piece for us? And then he began writing this piece after he had broken up with his girlfriend, and he was rather heartbroken.
This is his first love, right?
Yes, I would say. You can definitely hear some of those elements in this work. I don't think it's programmatic in a way, but certainly
passion.
Yes, and some beauty, and maybe a little bit of
anger.
And angst.
angst, that's a better word. Okay. One of the things I did ask him about, because at the end it goes up really high on the violin, and I asked him, why are you writing something up so high like that on the violin? And he said he was describing the beauty of his ex-girlfriend. So,
without further ado.
Yeah, here it is.
Thank you.
next piece we're going to play is originally for voice and piano, and this is a piece that's commonly played by guitarists as well.
Yeah, there's a guitarist I've played with many times. Originally it was seven songs for voice and piano. And for the instrumentalist version, most people only play the six movements. And the order of the movements actually is completely up to the performer, but there is a traditional order played in, which is the order that we're going to play in tonight. Defay was a Spanish composer and was really trying to, I would say, create almost a love story with these songs.
This is a classic set that's been recorded by many of the most famous Spanish sopranos of all time. It's very well known.
And being written for voice, follows text. And the first one, El Paño Moruno, is, I don't know if you would call it an old wives' tale, but it's basically the story of that one is that the cloth with the stain is worth not as much. And then there's the, that's a story the mothers would tell the daughters, I guess. The second movement is a lullaby. What's it called? Nana, right?
Yeah.
And it's very interesting the way that he wrote it. There's a real three against two, almost a four against three also, occasionally that shows up. So it sort of has this unstable feeling. But it's this mother that's supposed to be rocking her baby to sleep. And for any of us that have ever had children, you know that sometimes when you're trying to get that kid to go to sleep, they just won't. Dozing off yourself, it's not necessarily, like this real is this not.
But like any berceuse, you've got this undulating rhythm that just repeats the whole entire piece, just like in Chopin's berceuse.
But the words for that one is, please, baby, sleep. Please, sleep. pretty straightforward. And then the next movement? Okay.
Canción.
I was testing it. Which just means song. The words for this one is a little disturbing. It says, your eyes are so beautiful, so dark, I want to pluck them out and bury them. That's what it says. which leads us to the next movement, which is Polo. And it's very fiery, filled with a lot of passion.
This is the one that most obviously, where the piano is trying to sound like a guitar. And of course, when guitarists play it, They feel it's a little funny that they're a guitarist pretending to sound like a guitar. So it's one of those kinds of things.
And then which leads us to Asturiana. And again, this one has a little bit of strange lyrics. It says, I love this tree, so I want to sit down beside it. I see that it is weeping, so I will weep also. There you go. I guess if you had your eyes plucked out, you might cry. Which leads us to the last one. Jota, and in this one you'll really hear the piano, it really sounds like castanets. And this is sort of a story of forbidden love, and the very end of the piece ends with, until tomorrow, no matter what your mother thinks. So we're at the part of the program where we're going to start changing things up. As Dave was saying, sometimes we print our programs before we've learned everything. And this is one of those cases.
So while we were here, three Washington Lee students wrote three pieces for us. And we rehearsed these pieces with that composer and recorded the piece for that person. And they're short pieces for violin and piano, each just a few minutes long.
And so we decided, since we were playing a modern concert, what could be more modern than three newly written pieces? Right?
So the first piece is by Rachel Hodge, and this is called
Katsu Mouse.
There we go.
Make sure I got the right one. So the next song we'd like to play is by Thomas Day, and it's entitled The Dark Path.
Thank you.
piece is by Keegan Dolan, and this is a drive down Route 144, which is a little play on words. These are 12-tone pieces, and of course, it's self-explanatory, I guess.
So the piece to end our first half is another work by Matthew First.
And this is Diabolical Dances. And we approached Matt with the idea of coming up with a contemporary showpiece.
And as you might have noticed in the first piece that he wrote for us, can be technically very challenging. And in retrospect, we kind of ask ourselves what we were thinking asking for a showpiece from somebody that already challenges us. So he did not disappoint.
Yeah. Well, it's quite the tour de force in all ways. And hope you enjoy it.
Here it is. Thank you.